He says, "Ja'ilu al-malaikati rusula uli ajniha, having wings." And he say, "Mathna wa thulatha wa ruba'a." He say, "Wings, two, three, four." He increased Yazidu fil khalqi ma yasha. And Allah, He increases in His creation however He wishes. However He wishes. Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan hafidhahullah, he say, فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ لَهُ سِتَّمِئَ جَنَاح كَجِبْرِيلَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. He said, you have among them those who have 600 wings, like Jibril alayhi salatu wasalam. Those who have 600 wings, like Jibril alayhi salatu wasalam. He say, فَلَا يَعْلَمُ عَذَمُ خَلْقِهِمْ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And no one knows the greatness of their creature except Allah, meaning the angel. No one knows the greatness of their creature except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan hafidhahullah, he quoted another verse in Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 26 and 27. He say, "Bal ibadum mukramun," but rather they are noble servants. They are noble servants, meaning they are honorable servants. And he mentioned Barak Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, "Bal ibadum mukramun." He say, "La yasbiqunahu bil qawli." And they will not precede Allah in speech. They will not precede Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in speech. He say, but rather, he say, وَهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِ يَعْمَلُونَ. And only by the command of Allah do they carry out. Only by the command of Allah do they carry out. They will not precede Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any speech. But rather, barakallahu fikum, they act upon His command. They only act upon His command. وَمِنْهُمْ الْمُوَكَّلُ بِالْقَطْرِ وَالنَّبَاتِ. And those who are being in charge with the rain and likewise the vegetation. Those from the angel that was given the responsibility of dropping the rain and likewise bringing barakallahu fikum there, the plants, dropping the rain, and likewise the plants. And this angel, his name is Mika'il. Mika'il is the one that is responsible for the issue of dropping the rain, and likewise the nabat. Likewise the nabat, meaning the plants. وَهُوَ Mika'il, and this is Mika'il alayhi salatu wasalam. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ هُوَ مُوَكِّلٌ بِالنَّفْخِ فِي الصُّورِ. And likewise, those who are being given and trusted to be blowing the horn, to be blowing the horn, and everything will perish. When they will blow the horn, everything will perish. When they will blow the horn, everything will perish. He say, وَهُوَ Israfil, and this is Israfil, alayhi salatu wasalam. So Israfil is the one that is blowing the horn. Mika'il is the one that is in charge of what? Of the rain and the vegetation. Ahsanta. Jibril is in charge of the wahyu. He's in charge of the wahyu. So the Shafi'i dhahullahu ta'ala, he mentioned, he say, yanfukhu fi sur, that Israfil, he will be blowing the horn. He say, fayuhlak kull shay, and everything will be destroyed. Everything will perish. قال الله تعالى, as Allah the Most High mentioned, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Zumar, He mentioned, He say, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ, and the horn will be blown. فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and whoever is in the heavens and whoever is onto the earth will swan, meaning will drown down dead, will drop down dead, except whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes. Except whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes. So this will be the first blowing of the horn. Right? The first blowing of the horn is what? To terminate the world, end of life on this dunya, on this earth. The first one, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا ما شاء الله. So when the horn would be blown, by who? Israfil. That everything in the heavens and everything on the earth will barakallahu fikum, will drop dead. فَسَعِقَ will drop dead. إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ Allah, except that which is willed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning except whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. So this was the first blowing of the horn. ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ مَرَّةُ الثَّانِيَةِ. And the second time where the horn will be blown. The second time that the horn will be blown, Shaykh Saleh Al-Fawzan Hafidhahullah mentioned. He say, فَتَطِيرُ الْأَرْوَاحُ فِي أَجْسَادِهَا. When the second time the horn will be blown, he said that the soul will return to their bodies. The soul will be فَتَطِيرَ, meaning they will fly. الْأَرْوَاحُ فِي أَجْسَامِهَا, that أَجْسَادِهَا, that they will be flying to their bodies. They will be flying to their bodies. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Zumar, ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, and then it will be blown again. Then they will all be standing looking on. They will be all standing looking on. He said, تَطِيرُ الْأَرْوَاحِ مِنْ من القرن وهو الصور إلى أجسادها. And he mentioned that the soul will fly from the qarn, meaning the horn, and they will be going back to their bodies. They will be going back to their bodies, and they will be entering life. He say, فَيَحْيَوْنَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ أو فَيُحْيَوْنَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, and they will be gaining life by the permission of Allah. ثُمَّ يَسِيرُونَ إِلَى الْمَحْشَرِ, and they will be all proceeding to the gathering. Al-Mahshar, they will be all proceeding to the gathering place. So this is, alhamdulillah, one of the aspects of also believing in the hereafter. Believing in the hereafter. The Shahafidah Allah, he say, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ هُوَ مُوَكَّلٌ بقبض الأرواح عند نهاية أجالها. He say, likewise, those who have been entrusted to be taking the souls at the end of their lifespan. Those who have been entrusted to take the souls at the end of their lifespan. You remember that those four things, أربع كلمات, ويأمر بأربع كلمات, and he will be declaring four statements. One of them was the lifespan. One of them was the lifespan. So when the lifespan comes to its term, then you have angels that have been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take the souls of those whom that their lifespan has came to a term. And this is known to be وَهُوَ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ. It is Malakul Maut. قال الله تبارك وتعالى, Allah the Most High mentioned, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in regard to the angels of death, he says, say, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ, say, the angel of death, قُلْ, say, O Muhammad, يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ, say, that the angel of death who has been entrusted with you will take your souls. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ, and you shall all return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if one disbelieves in returning to Allah, nobody can disbelieve in death. If one is disbelieving in returning to Allah, then nobody can question about death. Because every single day you hear somebody getting shot. Everybody, you hear somebody, barakallahu fikum, being what? Drop dead. Everybody, you hear somebody sick at the hospital, dead. Everybody here, somebody has a stroke. What happened? Dead. Everybody, you every single day, barakallahu feekum, you hear somebody dead. Every single day you hear somebody got shot, somebody got murdered, somebody. So it is not about death that the people will deny. So therefore, whoever will deny that we will all return back to Allah, then look at death and look at life. You did not bring yourself into this life. And you did not have a choice of living this life. Because if there was a choice, then nobody would live this life. If there was a choice, nobody would want to live this life. To go in a 6-foot deep hole, dark, no AC, no light, no food, no drink, no nothing. So tight that the ribs can be interlocking. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So this is the day that barakallahu feekum we all have to prepare. And it is not what money can prepare. It is not what muscles can prepare. It is not what intelligence can prepare. It is not how smart can prepare. But the only preparation is isti'dad. The preparation is to line ourselves with qala Allahu wa qala Rasul. Allah said, the messenger said. This is the only preparation. And likewise, having a good circle of friends. Because you are indeed your friends. If your friends, they all smoke, believe it or not, you smoking. Whether you are first hand smoker or second hand smoker. Either or. If your friends they are cursing, listen, whether on you are a curse, you curse. Whether you say it or you hear it, the curse words, and you don't reprehend from it doing it. If your friends they rob or they do the likes of this dirt, you are doing it. Whether you partake into it or you are being a silent devil. And not telling them to stop. And not in condoning what they do. So we have to, alhamdulillah, have a good circle of friends. And who are the best circles of friends? Except those who are yuriduna wajah Allah. Those who are seeking the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not who those who all they matters is this life. All they care about is, I'm going to make it. Akhi, if you care about making it, that is not entitled you that you're going to make it. Those who are your friend are those who, alhamdulillah, you will study with. They will call you, akhi, let's go to the class. Akhi, let's go to the masjid. These are your friends. These are your friends, and they will be beneficial friends. Because when you die, they will be making dua for you. Any one of us, mention the name of our brother, rahimahullah, baba. All of us will say, rahimahullah. Limada? Because kunna nadursu ma'ahu. We used to study with him. Up until today. That anybody, barakallahu feekum, pass by the place that he died, we all make dua for him. Limada? Was it because we used to play soccer with him? Was it because we used to drink tea with him? Was it because we used to shoot the bobo with him? La, because we used to study together. But having friends that are criminals, it is only going to add to your evil. And worse, if you want to combine both. You want to be with the believers, but you want to be with those who are evil. You are worse than him. You are worse than him because he is not compromising, but you are compromising. Wasallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. If there was any mistake that I have done, please rectify me. May Allah rectify your affairs. And know that these 10 days are the best 10 days of the whole year. And inshallah ta'ala, it is for all of us to strive harder in regard to the actions that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that there is no actions that are more beloved to Allah than in these 10 days. The Sahaba, they say, قالوا يا رسول الله ولو جهاد في سبيل الله قال ولو جهاد في سبيل الله. Even striving in the cause of Allah, إلا except a person, رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع منهما شيئا. And except a person that goes out himself and his wealth, and nothing will come back. So let us not undermine any action, even if it is to smile at your brother's face, even if it is to give him a cup of water, even if it is to help him يحمل الأشياء على سيارته, even if it is to help him to load something in his car or to unload from his car. So this bab of Amal Salih, it is open. So let us not let anything go in these 10 days, knowing that